here to play this game, and I'm a risk taker. I mean, I quit my job as a CPA to become an entrepreneur. So to me, it was like, no brainer, I want to go. Like, I'm going to the Island of Idols, and I get to figure out what this is about. I'm excited. Like, we're going to have some fun.
Welcome.
Hi.
How's it going?
I feel so loved right now.
Hi,
I'm Noura.
Noura, Rob. Good to meet you.
Of course,
Hi,
I know who you guys
are.
Wow, Boston, Rob, and Sandra. I'm super excited to see them and meet them in person. Sandra is a two-time winner. Boston Rob's a winner.
Are you excited?
Yes, I can't believe no one else jumped on this. These are experts that are coming to you. They welcome me in and I'm feeling like, okay, maybe I can like talk to them about what's going on with my game and they can give me some advice. I am not a typical Survivor player. I feel like a novice in this game. And if it's anyone, I need these guys. In that moment, I'm like, I'm in the right place at the right time.
Well, let me fill you in a little bit.
Let's hear it.
So everybody that comes to the Island of the Idols gets a lesson. And your lesson today is about the art of persuasion.
Oh, wow. I need that.
Persuading people in this game is a very important skill that every player needs to have. In order to persuade someone effectively, you have to understand that person's motivation.
If you were to give up immunity, then I would believe you, and that would cue me that we're all gonna vote Amanda.
It has to line up with something that they want.
You're gonna need a pivotal move if you want a jury vote.
Mm-hmm.
If you can figure out what it is that this person wants, persuading them should be easy.
I wanna give individual immunity to Natalie.
Eric, the tribe has spoken.
I think that is what you call a life lesson.
Look, different people need different types of persuasion. You could appeal to like someone's ego.
Yeah, that helps.
You're a little baby monkey.
Yeah, your baby monkey.
I'm gonna flirt with him. Get him on my good side. It's what I do best.
You could try to scare someone, put fear into them to get what you want.
This is the other one. I'm asking you for both of our sakes to become my ally again.
Basically, Yul said, vote with us or you're going home tonight.
That's
or
true.
For me, rumors. You start a rumor.
I know, you're so good at that.
I heard Coach was saying that he wanted to get rid of you.
He's going behind my back saying stuff like that.
This is so stupid. He don't know what he got himself into.
What about this for that? You're offering him something in return for something else.
Yeah, that's more me. Mine is more intellectual of a connection.
Right. I can think of like an example from when I played, when I asked Lex to save Amber. I kind of enticed him with, if you can do something, I'll take care of you later.
If you can.
Lex, move it out.
It's very effective, but in hindsight, I ultimately didn't get his vote at the end of the day. So some would argue that he had the last laugh. We actually have some insight into your next immunity challenge.
Oh, that's amazing.
So listen up, this is important.
This is important, okay.
For your next immunity challenge, the tribe will be blindfolded. One person will be the caller. It's the most important role in the challenge. If you can persuade your tribe to let you be the caller, you will earn an advantage that allows you to block the vote of another player. If you fail to end up in the caller role, you lose your vote for the next tribal council.
I love this.
You're going to accept the test.
I'm doing it.
Think about it. Chew on your watermelon.
I'm doing it. I'm going
to
do it.
You have to weigh the risk and reward.
I'm doing it no matter what. I'm not thinking twice. I'm gonna push to be the person that calls it out.
Okay. If you think you can pull it off.
She didn't give it much thought. She just jumped on it. Like, she just took the offer and went with it. That's the mentality that she has. And that'll get her in trouble in the game.
In my opinion, Noura's the last person you'd want in the calling position. She cannot coherently communicate anything to anyone. She's living in Noura world. This is Survivor. You gotta be in Survivor world. She definitely is perceptive. The question is her perception reality?
When I hit the beach, I already am getting a little bit of anxiety because you got a big group and they're just like waiting for the Noura TV show to start and like click play. All right, so basically, I get there and get an advantage in the next immunity challenge that will benefit They basically gave us what the next immunity challenge is in detail. There's only one twist. It says that you guys have to unanimously agree on the role that I play in that challenge. Then I can tell you all the details. This is all a lie because I have the information and I could have just given it to them. But what I'm trying to do is secure that caller position, because if I can persuade my tribe to let me be the caller, I will get an advantage in this game. If they don't let me, I will lose my vote at the next tribal council.
How can we assign you a role without you telling us what the challenge
is? Basically, just say, yes, we unanimously decide that Noura can pick the role to do, and then I get to tell you the whole detail. Right. You'll see that that's why I need that role. Does that make sense? I'm doing the this for that. The idea is, oh, you want to know this information I have? Well, I need this commitment from you guys. So does everyone agree?
Yeah, everyone agrees.
You feel fine? Everyone's fine?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what it is. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so everyone's going to be blindfolded.
Okay.
And there's a caller.
Yep.
So that would be me.
Yeah.
So I call out, because now you've assigned me the position. Okay, so there's a caller. And people go out and, like, whatever we're retrieving, I have to guide each of you guys to go out on the course and bring it back.
Okay.
And whoever gets back first wins. That's it.
And did you want to be the caller?
Obviously, the role I want to have is the calling position.
Right. Okay. Noura presents us with this bizarre scenario in which we have to choose her role in an unknown game to have her reveal to us what the game is we're going to play tomorrow for the immunity challenge. If eyes could do full circles without being in a cartoon, our eyes would be doing full circles.
Can you explain to the tribe why you think you're the best person to be the caller?
It's already done. I gave you the information, so I already have that role. It's done.
Wait, well, let's listen to what I'm asking. You got to decide what role you wanted.
That's the only role, is the caller. I don't understand the question.
We had to unanimously decide that you could pick your role. So could you pick your role as a retriever?
Oh, I guess I could, yeah, I guess I could.
This is not a good lie. But it's really good that Noura is now so in this lie that there's no way that she's gonna talk about what's actually on Island of the Idols. So pressure's off of me, thank goodness.
It doesn't matter if I think I should be the best or not, it's that I could not tell you guys this information unless I pick the role. I guess in my mind I just decided I'm gonna be the caller.
Right.
Just that simply.
Right.
Because I have all the information. It is what it is, and we can't change it. Right now, they're not believing in me. They're questioning me, and honestly, I don't think I'm that bad of a caller. I feel like I have a big mouth, a big voice. Even if I was the worst caller, if we're practicing ahead of time and we know what we're going into, I think we should be fine.
Okay, you have one extra person. You gotta sit somebody out. Who's it gonna be?
Who we got?
Noura.
Noura.
Okay.
Nora's sitting out.
Noura.
I'm sitting out. You're sitting out.
Sure? Who's it gonna be?
Noura.
Noura. Take a spot on sit-out bench.
My tribe told me to sit out. So after all that, I lost my vote at the next tribal council.